so hard, but he just can't do it.
Mm-hmm. He's got to be very careful. He doesn't want to throw this away. We have seen EJK kill some workers, but now it's 25 SCVs.
Which means it's going to be an even better army intense. Supply,
intense is, yeah, that's a phenomenal point. Intense is good. Both have big gas banks, but they're really desperately trying to get gold minerals, which is what the gold will be good for Intense.
Yo, the gold minerals taste better than the blue minerals, man. Mm,
that's the mules. They eat them. Yeah, the SCVs, it's actually a very weird digestion thing that goes on with the minerals.
Better.
They taste better.
It's like Cheerios versus Honey Nut Cheerios.
Oh, is that even a thing? Do you have Cheerios? I feel like Honey Nut Cheerios.
Honey Nut Cheerios all the
way,
and that's what the gold minerals are. Mm-hmm.
The Honey Nut Cheerios of StarCraft.
Yeah.
That's what they are.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the Venn diagram is not there for EJK with his siege tanks. He's going to siege up, but he's forced to siege up farther away from Intense. And Intense is starting to make ground right here. Once again,
EJK will not die. He's like the fem boss from Austin Powers.
Yeah.
Just like, EJK's like, yo, I ain't dying, dude.
Yo, bro. This
Why
ain't,
won't
yeah,
you die? He ain't going down, but he's going to mine out eventually. That's the problem.
He gets to play mech. He's got siege tanks, man.
Hey, he's good. He's good. He gets to play mech.
That's a lot of tanks, though. But he doesn't have the medevacs to support it.
Yeah, man. This is like, okay, bio didn't work. I'll just transition into mech late game or something. But Intense has more siege tanks.
It's so hard.
EJK does, and EJK's got one siege tank left. I think really, like, all the hardness of this map came through the wall you have right here.
Yeah,
EJK, or pardon me, Intense can't jump up it. He can certainly leapfrog.
Well, if
he
go Mass Reapers, then he'll be able to jump up.
That's what, yeah, Mass Reaper, man. KDH charge those bad boys.
A little too much here for EJK, and I think this might be it. Checkmate, perhaps, as he's mined out in the main. I don't know about the natural, but he's down to 24 workers.
GG!
What a game.
Intense takes game one of a best of three.
Wow.
That was good. You can even see, ladies and gentlemen, we're looking at the cameras, like, both Temple and I are like, what? Oh, yeah, we're into the game. We're into this game.
Then
we
got to
bring back at the edge. At the edge of my seat, Tempo. Up next would be game two, or will be game two, Kappa. Not sure what that map that is. But we'll see. I mean, really right there, Intense's favorite thing was TVT, you were saying, and he played incredibly well. Oh, yeah, we got the crowd. We got the crowd reactions right here. Nice job from Intense taking that in. The winner of this, though, has to move up and play Epic in I think, technically, the semifinals of the losers
bracket
somewhere along in there. Kelazor's dropped down there from Huck earlier of the winners bracket.
Yep.
And the winner of this has to play Epic, though, and Epic, all the NA players are saying, this is the dude, this is the guy, and he wasn't quite, ooh, was it Kelazor? I can't quite remember. Wasn't quite able to beat someone earlier. Let me check that out for a moment. Looks like it was Epic versus Huck. Huck 2-1, or 2-0'd. No, he 2-0.
Oh,
that was incorrect.
Okay.
The brackets are wrong, man. Brackets be cursed, baby.
Can't trust him, man.
But even with that, he did, he was close. Huck even said, you know, like, maybe he's the up-and-coming dude in NA. He's playing
Do you know
well.
What team he plays for, or is he teamless right now?
Deadly Gaming.
Deadly Gaming.
Epic.
I have
Epicness of Deadly
before,
Gaming,
yo.
Man.
Has he joined any of the online tournaments that we've... I feel
ASL
like
Bacon,
the name,
maybe he has.
The name rings a bell.
Tempo and
be like, epic.
Epic, yeah. And then we'd be like, very putty intense. Kappa. Kappa, man.
Well, this is an intense series, is it not? Never used that one before.
Yeah,
I've never heard that one.
Never?
Never. Am
never.
I? No.
You haven't heard, like, whoa, that's so intense. Or let's rough?
Nah. Oh,
wow.
That's just a rough match. First
you never
time.
Heard that, though. First time.
Here.
Oh, man. I'm.
We innovate here at the Cheese Adelphia.
It's okay.
Number two, by the way. And I'm hoping there will be a number three.
The number one cheese in Adelphia tournament. This is
I had
number
a
one cheese
steak.
Tournament in the U.S.,
I had a
cheese
steak,
man.
By the way. It was pretty delicious.
Oh, you like it?
I liked it. I'm getting another one, too.
What type was it?
The one with the cheese and the steak.
So you like the cheese and the steak better? Cheese and the steak better, man. Like, which one?
Oh,
which
no. one? It's a deadly combination. You know what I'm saying?
Like Deadly Gaming's Epic, who the winner of this will be playing against. But we're going to have to see in the top right-hand corner from Team Gravity. It is the blue Zerg player, the one, the only, EJK.
Yeah. Woo! And the fangirls go crazy. Got to hold them back. Mm. And then the other side of things, representing my insanity, give it up for Intense. Look at him. He's like so focused right now.
Oh man, yeah, and look at that screen, man. They're both really focused.
Yeah.
And you can see the bottom
EJK,
right.
You know he's a true gamer because he has the gamer glasses on.
Oh yeah, he's got the gamer to protect his eyes
from the bright light.
If it explodes.
Well,
it's the
bright light from the you know how that keeps them all illuminated.
Mm-hmm. They got some bright lights behind them. Keep them well illuminated so you ladies and gentlemen can watch them.
So EJK is going for a double gas opener here while it looks like Intense is kind of sticking to what he did before. You know, he might go for the Reaper expand again. However, this map is not the greatest for Reapers, you know. If you actually wall off, I don't think you can jump up the cliff. Mm-hmm. I don't think
you got to jump up into the main and then, jump up in the natural and then go to the main. So it'd be a little bit wonky.
Oh, a little different here. He's adding a reactor here to the barracks. Yeah. While it looks like EJK's teching up super fast.
That is very interesting. Some maps, you do have to obviously make the reactor to complete the wall, but not the situation on the other side. What do we have for EJK? He's got the factory on the way. And for Intense, it's the natural CC.
Yep.
We're seeing a little bit different clustering, or maybe even the same. Like, EJK, best defense is lots of offensive units. Like, you can't touch him. That's how he plays. But he's still looking to capitalize off it a little bit better in some of these games. Like, in this one, he's not quite playing his bio style. Maybe he's deciding the mech.
He's like, you know what?
Mech good.
Yeah. I mean, to be honest, he's getting a tech lab here already. So, usually, if he was going to go for Banshees, I think you assume... Oh, no. He did make it. Oh. Yeah, he's going to go right for it. So...
EJK switching that up. You know, he says he likes bio, but hey, bio players can go Banshee, man.
Oh, yeah, you can still open it up. It's one of the most classic two-gas openers for TVT.
Classic two-gas openers. Those are some good ones, man. I love the classic ones.
This is Tide of the Storm. I mean, maybe. I would assume this, though. Oh, unless he gets, if he pulls a rough and gets, the Raven upgrade and then starts dropping, auto turrets all over the place. I don't think that's what we're going to see, though. Mm-hmm. Oh, God. Yeah, intense. Mm-hmm.
Looks like the SCV earlier on of EJK went down to these Marines, but it sees the natural, and I feel like for EJK, that's like, oh, I should have a natural. I should probably have a natural.
Well, the thing about it is that it means Intense is not going to be able to have as many units. His tech is going to be delayed in favor of the economy. So the Banshee needs to do something here. Intense? I don't know if he scouted, though.
No, man, he's hanging back. Let me check
that
out.
Does he even know where EJK spawned?
If that Banshee hits him, he's not going to be able to counterattack, which I feel like is kind of what Intense does. Like, okay, you attack me, I'll just attack you.
Attack you back. The fact that he's focusing so much on the economy means that it's going to be all right for now. But the problem is he doesn't have anywhere to scan, he can't do a timely scan in order to know what's going on. So
even if he scans it, he's got to get an engineering bay down, then get a missile turret, and then he needs Marines.
And his Marines need to be in position, too.
Yeah, there's a lot of things that are not coming well together for Intense in this game, too. He is up 1-0, though, in this best of three.
Yeah.
The Banshee's coming on over, and what's its name?
Her name is...
Oh, yeah, good point.
Belinda.
Belinda. Okay, Belinda is moving on in, and hopefully she can pick up some kills.
Yeah.
Pick up some stray SCVs in the street.
You know what I'm saying? Liberate them.
Liberate some of those SCVs, baby.
Not even as a liberator, but the Banshee might cross paths. Oh, it doesn't.
Barely doesn't.
I don't think the Marines are in position.
Looks like in the main base, there's no Marine. Oh, there's one Marine. That's Carl. Carl cannot do anything against Belinda. Belinda is completely invisible moving on in. And
going
to focus down the SCV of the barracks. And that's when you get an engineering bay that's almost done. The Banshee could focus it down if it wanted to. There's a scan.
But what is that going to do? There's nothing to shoot it.
And he wastes that. That's huge. There needs to be a Viking. There's a Cyclone, but it's going to fall back. It doesn't have energy. Cyclones are ready, but my Belinda.
She's quite
the woman, Belinda.
You know what I'm saying? That's when you can take home to mom, and be like, hey, I'm proud of my life choices here.
A Banshee that went in and had to fall back?
Yeah. She's committed,
Very committed. She's going to go in again on the top left, pushing in, while there's a secondary Banshee from EJK headed towards the natural.
Uh-huh. Well, he can still get a few kills with some good micro, and... that's a Cyclone, so he is going to be able to lock on to it.
Oh, and uses the scan to have the extra range, but he doesn't lock on! It's going to waste it! The scan, that's two scans with nothing, and now there's a Banshee at the natural.
Nothing at all. Well, that's kind of an issue, I mean, it's not a huge issue, but it sucks, because you want to take out that Banshee. It's just going to be kind of annoying. EJK double expanded behind it as well, I believe.
Yeah, he's got a third CC just finishing up, and that is on the way. And this is everything going in his favor. Game one, it just snowballed, landslide, and ended up in Intense. This time, EJK is like, okay, you know what? I can do the same thing.
Yeah. Well, luckily for Intense, he hasn't taken a crazy amount of damage.
He's just wasted six workers.
Yeah, six workers from two Banshees. That's not bad at all, considering the fact that he didn't have a turret up when the first Banshee came out.
That's a very good point. He did do a very good job at that. Wasted a few scans, but you know what the bright side of that is? There's not a ton of Marines like there traditionally is for EJK's bio style. He's not going to have quite as many at home, and Intense, he's liking them
dropped. Oh, suck it, Hellion! Get wrecked! Did you see that?
Get wrecked, man. get
it's like
wrecked.
A landmine in the middle of the street. Mm-hmm. You got to like do a two-wheelie, you know?
The two-wheelie, I think you have to jump over it. You can't.
Like Rocket League?
Rocket. No. This is on a bike, and you gotta like have your friend throw a ramp in front of you, and you gotta jump over it, man. That's literally like you can't go around it. That's the only way.
Well, back at the home of EJK, you know, he didn't do that much damage, but he did set up with the triple command center. Hasn't taken any damage himself, and he's gonna try to do something else here with the Banshee.
Belinda, what are you doing, Belinda? That's dangerous.
It is
There's
dangerous.
There's a scan and a stim forward, but it's the perfect map architecture, and that allows the Banshee to fall back out of the sight of the scan and the Marines.
That must be so annoying.
That's very sad.
There it is.
Belinda. Rip Belinda.
Hey, I guess we're just gonna have to find another bay.
Another Banshee.
Another Banshee.
Banshee, yeah, man. Looks like EJK is going to have a Viking falling back and this may be killed. That's gonna be very important for the Tankovac battles that are going to come. There are two Tankovacs heading out over, and the Cyclone's gonna barely get away, and EJK, he's done damages.
That's such an expensive unit too.
Yeah. He actually is not quite prepared. He needs a siege up.
Well, oh boy. Is he really not going to siege up? He's just going to try. He needs to. He doesn't have any Marines to support it.
There's nothing.
Oh,
there's the
no.
siege, but
he's
it's going to
lose everything. Down goes one tank, two tank, three tanks. We can count. It's like Sesame Street. The one, a two,
a three, a four.
Uh-oh.
No, it's not going to be too good
EJK.
For him.
EJK. That triple command center is not even going to come into play here. And Intense is going to siege on up. Drenok.
Yeah.
Is this the end?
It looked so good for him with those Banshees, but there was not enough damage done.
Mm-mm.
And he wasn't able to transition. If he didn't go Banshee, maybe he'd have a lot of tanks, Marines, if he opted the other way. And right here, it's not looking too good with this 61 army supply of Intense to the 28 of EJK. And Intense, man, after winning game one, game two has actually fallen into his hands in a beautiful manner.
And he's taking a third behind it. His upgrades are going to be finishing pretty... I mean, he already has plus one. EJK is going for the 1-1 at the same time with
Banshee.
Oh,
no, what am I? Oh! Rip the dude in the front.
Yep. Sucks to be that guy. It's like, yo, man, I didn't.
No. Someone's like, hey, Joe, you know what? You're gonna be at the front of the
you're
line.
Lead the pack,
and he's gonna be like, yeah.
You're gonna be something, bro. You got it. But Intense is looking to kind of choke out EJK. Even if he doesn't kill him here, he's mining from the third now, and he's about to finish his plus. No, he's not. He has plus one attack. He does not have the plus one armor just yet. But he does have, you know, all of the crucial upgrades for his Marines, and he has the better tank count.
He's got everything ready, exactly. It is six tanks of Intense, the two, and EJK. I love the
perfect
attack
timing.
Each other. Both of them are like, let's do this, and the brawl ensues. They both headbutt each other.
SCVs are too late, too late.
And they are
into the meat grinder they go. And now it is going to be Intense taking it.
Good luck,
Intense. Going to be playing against Epic next in another TVT.
Intense 2-0s. EJK, game one, build order went Intense's way. He just did the Artosis thing. Mm-hmm. If thieth in fronteth, stay in fronteth.
Is that what he said?
Yeah, that's basically what he said.
Exact quote?
Yeah, exact quote. He said that to me in my sleep. I had a dream, and he said, Drenok, if thieth in fronteth, stayeth in fronteth, economically eth.
I like.
That's what he went with, but
we're such a wise
now
man,
Intense
is
going to have to. Oh, we had the delayed collapse.
Woo!
Yeah!
Well done. Intense, you know, very, very solid player. And I think he's smiling on it right now. He's like, good, another Terran, let's go.
Oh, yeah, man. And Intense came here, and I was like, oh, I haven't played in a while. But, you know, I can
making Penguin
can do
proud.
It. Making Penguin proud, truly.
He's here today as well.
You know, I have a little secret for you.
What's that?
The back of Intense's jersey is his new name.
What's
it says Intez.
Intez?
Intez. Misspelling right there, but Intez.
No, really? Why are you always exposing people, bro? What the hell? You exposed me for my hat first, and now?
Oh, man. I don't know if I can. Jeez. Can I expose our production guy? I don't know if I can.
Nah, man.
I don't got nothing on
he
him.
He keeps it on lockdown.
All right.
Dude, 439 APM for Intense there. 365, that's all day,
that's,
every day.
That's
every
Intense,
year.
Like, not practicing in the past couple weeks. Like, you know, I rest my wrists, and I come back to the game, and I'm re-exhilarated.
All that essay writing, yo. I heard he's in school as well.
Oh, yeah, man. He was telling me that in college he didn't think it would be hard, and now he's like, oh, I didn't realize it would be hard.
Yeah. I guess it depends where you go and what classes you take.
Okay, he's in computer science, so, man, he can type things. He can type.
Word.
Up next, we will have Intense versus Epic. That'll be after a short ad break. Thanks, guys, for tuning in. This is Cheezadelphia 2. That is Tempo, the amazing Tempo. I'm Drenok, and we'll be right back.
Eddie Smurphy,
back.
A.K.A.
A.K.A. Eddie Smurphy on EU server. But we'll be right back after this short break for Epic, I think, versus Intense.
Intense.